dip the pecho on the toyo mansi with sili. Tapos, yung kanin, lagyan natin ng konting chicken oil. Just try it all together. Mmm! Wow! Wow! What's up, you guys? Kilianch here, and we're here at 8 Seas Food Adventure Food Park for one reason: the chicken inasal. And it's not your ordinary chicken inasal, guys. It's Bacolod Chicken Inasal, brought by a chef born and raised in Bacolod. I've been really wanting to try the real stuff, and so let's go inside. Let's check it out.
Pang basting namin yan sa lahat. Yan ang isol, yan ang chicken neck, garlic chorizo, hamonado chorizo, pecho, napaka, native chicken. Ibibase niya yan first na chicken oil to give it the delicious look. What I saw here sa mga inasal restaurants, they are not that authentic anymore. That is why pinasok ko yung Soogba. I serve Bacolod authentic inasal na talagang Manokan country vibe. The most authentic chicken inasal that you will have dito sa Metro Manila. Yan ang satay rice namin. Fried garlic. Woo!
Sabi, first time ko mag-vlog ng ihaw-ihaw. Saya. Nakakagutom yung amoy.
Pinakamatagal maluto yung native chicken. Chewy ang meat. But ang lasa, napakasarap.
Ito yung bulalo na cut. It's 500 grams. It's good for 4 to 5 kung gusto nyo pa i-stretch. This is Batwan. Not 2, ah, Batwan. Ito yung langka.
Okay.
And then sealing green to make it aromatic, tanglad.
So meron na akong stock. Lalagay mo ang tanglad to infuse the flavor sa sabaw. Pag kumulo na siya, lalagay mo na rin yung meat mo.
Meron kaming tinimpla na achuete sa sabaw mismo. Lalagay namin to mamaya. Pag lumambot na yung meat, dun mo na ilalagay si langka, and then lagyan mo siya ng batwan. This is very sour. Lalagyan mo siya according to taste.
Lagyan natin ng konting asin.
Parang siyang mild sampal. Lutuin ng mga butahe din sa kitchen. Sobrang intense ng experience. This is my first time. My first ihaw-ihaw vlog. And it's the authentic chicken inasal. Famous din sa kanila, yung mga soups nila. Mahilig sila sa mga comforting soups. Which is similar to our bulalo and sinigang. And this is Kansi right here. Para siyang nagpakasal yung bulalo and sinigang. And ito yung anak nila. Very beefy. Yung saltiness niya, salt lang yun, yung pampalasa. But you can really taste that mild batwan flavor. Para siyang sampalok pero mild. Let's try the beef. Mmm. Mmm. It's so good. It's my first time eating langka on a soup. Mmm. Very soft. Yung lasa nung sabaw, na-soak na siya. Para siyang sponge. Lasang-lasa din yung tanglad. Na kasama sa pagpapakulo. And it's very fragrant as well. Ito yung pamatay dito. Para siyang scallop. Sa bulalo, kukuha ka ng utak, lalagyan mo kalamansi para mabalance yung fattiness. Ito, dahil sinigang na rin siya, yung flavor of the batwan mixes into that. So it cuts through the fattiness. Let's try the original spirit. Yung recipe, parang 6 to 7 years na niyang na-master. And he brought it here in Soogba, one of his best-selling dishes. It really looks tender, cooked medium well. So let's try it out. Lambot, very juicy and moist, cooked perfectly. It's not overly salty, really good. Yung satay rice nila. Ito yung tipo na ulam na hindi mo pwedeng mapakit. Not just one rice, but triple rice. Talagang bagay dito. It's a must na mayroon din mga sauces na to. We have the calamansi and toyo. Yung gawa nila ng chicken oil. And then they have the spiced vinegar, which they call sinamak. This is their bestseller sa chicken inasal nila. This is the pecho part. Look at that. Very tender. First I tasted was the tuba. I always go for the pecho. Whether I'm on a diet or gusto kong kumain na mas maraming rice, you have more protein. For me, it's very sulit. I'd go back for this. Dip the pecho on the toyo mansi with sili. Yung kanin, lagyan natin ng konting chicken oil. Rice pa. Sarap. Bite. Wow. Wow. Now let's try the native chicken, which is served half chicken. It's very lean, kaya hindi mo siya pwedeng i-serve ng parang by part lang eh, kasi parang medyo magmumukha siyang liit. It's a little tough. Just because it's native, it's lean, it's just more flavorful compared to a regular chicken because it's natural and it's free range. Try na natin yung regular chicken leg. Juicy, tender, just how it's supposed to be. Very moist. Look at that. Wow. Bawal diet dito. Kaya yung kamay ko, dami ng pinagdaanan. Ganito pala pag nagkakamay sa Bacolod, ano? Mga mag-iiba ng kulay yung kamay mo dahil dun sa atsuwete. This is not your ordinary chicken inasal. Lahat masarap. Yung lasa ng chicken oil, ang layo sa chicken oil ng mga inasal. Tignan nyo yung oil, naninikit-nikit pa siya. Oh. Smoky. Tsaka ang deep ng flavor niya. Ito rin appetizer nila. So we got the spicy neck, sweet and garlicky chorizo, batikolon, and the chicken liver. Let's start with the spicy neck. Usually, ang mga nakakain ko lang na neck part is yung mga fried. Alam mo yung mga canto fried chicken? Ngayon lang yata ako makakatry ng grilled. Wow. Ang hanga niya. Kailangan ko ng kanin. Siyempre, sobrang lasa ng balat, diba? Yung spiciness niya, hindi siya para sa mga patwitams. Kailangan prepared ka. Okay siya sa akin. Kailangan lang siya masundan agad ng kanin para kahit pa paano matame yung spiciness niya. Pwede mo i-pair sa kanin or beer. Sobrang sarap nito. Next, try natin yung atay ng manok. Lambot, ah. Butter. So good. Now let's try the batikolon. Batikolon has a unique texture. Para siyang crunchy and chewy at the same time. Para siyang yung texture ng bituka ng baboy and isaw ng manok. Pinagsama dito. Let's try two different kinds of chorizos. The sweet one and the garlicky one. Let's try the chorizo, the sweet one. It's sweet, but it's not overly sweet. Alam niyo kung ano bagay dito, yung sinamak. Yeah, sobrang bagay siya sa vinegar. It cuts through sa sweetness niya. Ano, sarap ng char. It's so good. I can keep eating all these in one sitting. Kung wala pa ako ibang kakainin. Hindi ko kakainin eh. Anyways, ang sarap. Now let's try the garlic one. Garlicky, salty, a little peppery. Hindi overwhelming yung lasa niya. Yung suka, hindi mo na siya kailangan timplahan because it has already spices in it. Malasa na siya. Pairs really well with these two chorizos. Really, really good. Lastly, chicken ass. They call it isol. Kuha natin yung pinakamalaki. I don't normally eat chicken ass, okay? Pecho person ako eh. May kakaiba talaga siyang lasa eh, no? Hindi siya kalasa ng leeg, ng skin ng normal leg, fat, bomb. Try natin siya sa toyo mansi. Sarap! Flying kiss! Walang tapon sa lahat ng natikman ko today. But my favorites are, number one ko is that pecho. In terms of sulit factor, flavor, hindi siya overcooked. It's still juicy. And that's number one na hinahanap ko sa pecho or breast part. My second favorite is the chorizo. Ang sarap with the sinamak. And then, yung lasa nung native chicken. Hindi mo siya mahanap sa lasa ng ibang klaseng chicken. Siya lang yun. Next to that is the spicy neck. I love the spiciness and the flavor. And the isol. Siyempre, hindi siya yung araw-araw mong kainin. Kung gusto mong mag-indulge into something fatty, pair it with beer, or gusto mong kainin with kanin, chicken ass. Oh! May nakalimutan ako. Yung spare ribs. It's really tender and really juicy, really flavorful, and it's really good. And that's it for today's vlog. I hope you liked the video. I just want to take this opportunity to thank you all for watching and supporting my collaboration series with Chopstick Travel. And it's one of the best collaborations I've had since I started vlogging. The channel has grown so much. It has a huge impact. As of now, we're almost at 4,000 subscribers. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much, Luke and Sabrina, for collaborating with me. I'm really grateful for the friendship that we have built. I can't wait to do another series with you when you get back to the Philippines. And I'm also about to publish another series, but this time in Hanoi, Vietnam. And I'm really excited to share with you all the things that I've experienced there. The food, the culture, the history, and beautiful people. So I'll see you on the next episode. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe, and leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you. Click the notification bell so that you get notified on the first episode in Hanoi, Vietnam. And I'll see you there.